tell you guys what's going on. So what you just saw was pretty much me dying over and over again to the boss, Dragon Slayer Ornstein, and Executioner Smoke in Dark Souls. And what you're looking at now, it's going to be pretty much me defeating them. And this is the first time that I've defeated them. And it was a really big thing. At least for me, it was really tough. So I'm just happy to show it to you guys. But more importantly, is that there's something that I do want to talk about. And what I want to talk about was pretty much, I guess, the euphoric, I guess, happiness that I felt when I defeated these bosses. And I think it's something really important, and I wanted to really, I guess, let it out. But what it comes down to, really, is the fact that I haven't really felt that way for a game in a very, very long time. And I mean a really long time, probably, I mean, all the way back to the GameCube, maybe, was the last time that I felt sort of this real, crude, raw happiness by, you know, just playing a game. And it's something really bizarre, because I have a lot of games that I play every day. I have Borderlands, I have Torchlight 2, Skyrim, Counter-Strike, the new one that just came out. I have Left 4 Dead. I mean, it's just so many games that I play every day, but I don't really get to feel this immense sense of happiness and, I guess, challenge that Dark Souls provides. And it's something that I felt that is so bizarre. And I was thinking about, you know, why is that happening? Why am I keep getting drawn into this game when all I do really is rage and I get angry and throw controllers and scream at the TV? But even still, even after all that, I keep coming back to Dark Souls. I keep trying to defeat that boss, which is impossible, which feels like I'll never beat him, but I keep trying and trying, and eventually I do. And it's this really bizarre thing that I really didn't understand why that is. Why was I coming back to this game when all I was doing was raging? And then I was looking back at the other games, you know, every time I played Borderlands 2, I was having a blast. I always had fun with it, but it usually would come a point to where I would die and I would just like, all right, so that's it, and I'll just play something else. And then I wouldn't play Borderlands for like 2 days straight. You know, it was this really weird thing where I was coming back to Dark Souls and not to these other games, and I didn't really understood why. I had this level 51 character in Guild Wars that I haven't played in a month. And I was a big fan of Guild Wars back in the day, but I wasn't coming back to it, and I didn't know why. And I was thinking about it, and I think I figured out. Dark Souls has the power of immersion, and let me go ahead and explain what that is. So, the thing with Dark Souls is that you will usually not going to be able to simply go through the game and defeat it. You're going to get stuck in many different points throughout the game, and to advance through those spots where you're stuck, you're going to have to research about the game, you're going to have to look into the game, you're going to have to Google things, secrets, tips, tricks. You're gonna have to find, where should I get this new weapon? Where am I gonna get this awesome armor? What can I do to defeat this area that is kicking my ass? And I think that's where the strength of Dark Souls really comes to. You're gonna get stuck and you're gonna get deeper into the rabbit hole. You're gonna search deeper what this game is all about. How can I do this? How can I master this? And then you're gonna improve in your game. You're gonna pass through the area and then you're gonna get stuck again, and you're gonna go even deeper, searching deeper for results, for how to get better. How can I master this new area? How can I improve myself so that I can be better at the game to try to advance through this game? And then again, the same thing will repeat itself over and over again until there comes a point where you just realize, holy crap, I know so much about this game. I am so into this game. I am so immersed into this game that I love it. I just can't get enough of it. And I think that's really the strength of this game. And after continuing to think about it, I realized that really not many games have this. And the reason for that is that it seems like developers make games too easy. Like, I'm playing against Skyrim, and it's not a hard game. Skyrim is not a hard game, but not just Skyrim, really any game. Like, if you go and play Mass Effect, you're gonna finish it. If you just play it, you're gonna finish it. Like, there's really no question about it. And really any game, the new Super Mario's Wii, you play it, you're gonna finish it. But if you play Super Mario 3 on the SNES, you may not even finish it, because it's a tough game, which means that you're just gonna get more into it, you're gonna try harder, and you're gonna sort of invest yourself more into the game. And I think really that's what makes it, I guess, just stand out a little more. But I mean, you guys should have seen my face when I destroyed this boss, when I finally killed it. It was euphoric. Like, I was jumping and just like sort of like shouting in happiness, and it sounds a little corny, but I was literally like euphoric happy. Like I suddenly my mood just turned into complete happiness, and that's something that I haven't felt in a very, very long time. Is trying to have having a goal and have that goal crushed many, many times, and then just suddenly sort of like make it happen by just continued effort and trying over and over again and trying to get better at the game and improving yourself and mastering the art of the game. And for whatever reason, which are the reasons that I just explained, I think it made me really happy when I finished the boss, and it's something that I haven't felt in a long while, and I wanted to share this with you guys. And I wanna hear your guys' opinion on the matter. If you have felt this euphoric happiness when finally achieving a goal, and what game was it, and how long ago it was, I'm very curious to hear what you guys have to say. But I hope you guys enjoyed this little commentary that I was really inspired to do, and hope you all stay gamers, guys.